All Longhorn fans love Bevo, but probably not as much as a unique group of 2,000 fans and a man named Mac did back in 77. Hey, I'm Michael Callahan, and on this forgotten day in Longhorns football presented by Direct Energy, October 28, 1977, the AP reported that a 1951 UT grad named Mac McKenzie was making jewelry out of actual cow chips from Texas's beloved mascot, Bevo. Yeah, you heard me right. And if you think his idea stinks, literally, the bottom line is that at least 2,000 people disagreed with you. The firm handling orders for Bevo Chip Jewelry had already received more than 2,000 orders from 18 different states at press time. Side note, none of those orders came from Oklahoma or Arkansas. Go figure. But to understand Texas fans' love of Bevo, we should go back to the beginning. In 1916, after being purchased in the panhandle for a measly $124, thanks to $1 donations from Texas alums, Bevo first appeared at halftime of a 7-7 tilt with Texas A&M on Thanksgiving Day. He was originally called Bo, and his appearance at the game was quickly considered good luck as the Longhorns prevailed 21-7. Now, after the game, Ben Dyer of the UT campus magazine Alcalde said, "His name is Bevo. Long may he reign." All right, whether you believe Dyer named him after a little-known near beer from Anheuser-Busch called Bevo, or it was just derived as slang from the plural form of the word beef, beeves, Bevo has indeed reigned over the Texas sidelines for nearly 100 years. From a collision with Earl Campbell in the end zone in 77, to watching over an electrifying performance in the 06 national title game, 14 different Bevos have been there for it all. Sadly, Bevo number 14 passed away on October 16th, 2015, after being diagnosed with cancer. But let's try and keep this light and get back to the Bevo chips. Now, back in 77, McKenzie proudly said, "You can imagine the effect of 50,000 fans in the stands all rubbing their Bevo chips." Yeah, Mr. McKenzie, we can. Sounds pretty smelly. But thankfully, the Bevo chips were placed inside of mini plastic footballs before they were worn. Thank God. Clearly, this jewelry was unique, but what is your personal favorite piece of Texas Longhorns memorabilia? Share it with us in the comments below or tweet me, Michael Callahan at MCallahanTV, using hashtag ForgottenDayUT. We want to see your pictures.